الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد, حبيبتي, the question was asked, what are ways we can call to the Dawah to Ahl Sunnah? And I think this question has been dealt with in a variety of ways by the Imams of Ahl Sunnah throughout history, in fact. And especially in contemporary times, many books have been written, many treatises have been studied and taught, dealing with the various means for da'wah ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The da'wah to Ahl Sunnah is da'wah to the book and the Sunnah. And as is very befitting, as Imam Muqbil bin Hadi al-Wadi'i, Allah yarhamuhu, mentioned, he said, da'wah to Ahl Sunnah, da'watun min kitabillah ila kitabillahi ila kitabillah wa min sunnati rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam ila sunnati rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So he said the da'wah of Ahl Sunnah, this call to Ahl Sunnah, this da'wah of Ahl Sunnah, it is a call from the Quran to the Quran, or from the book of Allah to the book of Allah, and from the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam to the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So it's very important that we know and we keep the purpose of da'wah. That is such a beautiful, that's why I memorize that statement, because it's so concise, clear, plain, beautiful, simple, and right to the point. That should be the origin and the ending of our da'wah, that it is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it should be based on the principles of calling from the book of Allah to the book of Allah, and from the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam to the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So, you know, there it's not to, which is the opposite, which is hizbiyah, to call to ourselves, call to our jama'at, call to our groups, our sects, call to our Sufi sheikhs that go to Mecca in Medina every night, and they live in, you know, Siberia, or they live in, you know, Chechnya, or they live in Cameroon, or they live in Nigeria, and you know, they're always making hajj every few minutes. You know, it's not to that. So it's not to bid'ah, it's not to khurafat, it's not to our desires, but rather it's to the Quran and the Sunnah. And the Quran and the Sunnah are what we use to adjudicate, to judge by, and judge our da'wah in according to the book and the Sunnah. And the Prophet ﷺ said, I left you on two clear things. The Laylaha al-Kennahariha. You know, the it's night is like it's day. And no one goes, deviates from it, except that they're destroyed. And then he said, Kitabillah wa Sunnati. He said, the book of Allah and my Sunnah. So really, that is the way. Now, get more specific. That means we need ilm. That means knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, في كتاب الكريم فَعْلَمْ أَنُّهُ لَا إِلَىٰ إِلَىٰ اللَّهُ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذِنْبِكَ. Know that, فَعْلَمْ أَنُّهُ لَا إِلَىٰ إِلَىٰ اللَّهُ, that there is no God worthy of worship except Him. إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذِنْبِكَ. So, and seek forgiveness for your sins. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us a command to have knowledge. And knowledge of what? Knowledge of Tawheed, knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet ﷺ also mentioned that the haqq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that we worship Him and Him alone. The Prophet ﷺ also mentioned that we need talib al-ilm faridatun ala kulli muslim wa muslima, that seeking knowledge is an obligation upon every Muslim male and Muslim female. So we know we need knowledge. We need knowledge of what? We need knowledge of the book and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And there's so much evidences that affirm this for us and confirm this for us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, wa'ati'u Allah wa'ati'u Rasul. Obey Allah and obey His messenger. The only way you can obey Allah and the only way you can obey His messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam is by learning something from the book of Allah and learning something from the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's the only way that you can have obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we're going to call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to have some knowledge. So that way we have knowledge of the people we're talking to. We have to have knowledge of what we're calling to, which is Tawheed, which is to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, which is to follow the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is the qawa'id and usul and minhaj of Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah. So we need knowledge of that. So we need knowledge of what we're calling to. We need knowledge of who we're calling. So for example, if you know someone were to have knowledge, but they're going to an audience that doesn't even speak their language, or maybe they speak the language of the people, but they know nothing about their culture. They're totally, you know, away from their culture. Then there's a chance that they may have less impact than someone who is from amongst those people, who speaks the language, who knows the culture of those people. You know, especially if there's no commonalities, if there's nothing similar. For example, you bring a scholar, even one of our scholars that we may love from Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah, and they're coming from Saudi Arabia. You bring them to a community of Warith Deen Muhammad, you know, Warith Deen Muhammad community. And you want him to call them to Tawheed, which is Khair Azeem. This is beautiful. However, those people, because of their cultural baggage, are going to be much less accepting of someone who's not from their culture, because a big part of their dawah and their methodology has to do with their culture, and it comes from culture, and they move from the nation to that Warith Deen, and then from there many of them embrace the sunnah, the message of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or have a foot there and a foot there. Okay, so they respond more to someone who is like them. Likewise, you go to a community of wealthy some other culture, wealthy Arabs, wealthy Pakistanis, wealthy whoever. So the social status is different, okay? And you are maybe someone who is from a different culture, but and you don't have, they can't relate to you. Even the way you talk, you're talking Qala Allah, Qala Rasul, and they just don't relate to that, unfortunately. Or maybe the style is too rough for them, that they need examples that that relate to their experience. Nothing wrong with that. But as long as you're not, the Dawah is not being destroyed. The point is you need wisdom. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands to give Dawah with given this mawada, with hikmah, with hikmah, with wisdom. That you're calling with wisdom. So that takes fiqh fi deen wa fiqh fi the people that you're calling. Fiqh fi da'wah. So there's many aspects of fiqh with regards to da'wah. And so the point being, habita fillah is the da'wah to Ahl Sunnah, is the da'wah from the book and the sunnah. So how do we call the people? We call the people in accordance to their level. We call the people in accordance with their experience. We teach them the principles. So if you have a community that is not, they are scared of the word Salafi, and they're scared of the books of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, and they're scared of this and they're scared of that. That doesn't mean you change your principles, but you give them da'wah to Ahl Sunnah. You give them the da'wah to Tawheed, da'wah to Kitab wa Sunnah. But your packaging might not be the same in the way that you would talk to a community that's already strongly grounded in the sunnah and already used to students of knowledge and already used to a certain type of asloob or way of transmitting that knowledge. So it's going to be very different. So, and there's many examples, some of the ulama they mention about and this is something that it was really, I heard it more than one occasion. Abu Salah al-Afghani mentioned it, and also Sheikh Abu Salah and Sheikh Abdul Razak al-Badr mentioned it. And Sheikh Abu Salah, he went in details, giving me an indication that this happened in Afghanistan, if I recall. And it could happen in more than one place. But the point being that there was every week in a certain locality, and I believe it was in Afghanistan, you know, it was probably a Sufi Sheikh or what have you. And they spoke really, you know, the Wahhabis this, the Wahhabis that, and, you know, would just speak really ill about Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab and really the Dawah to Ahl Sunnah, okay? Because of their misunderstanding of what they heard, not even based on knowledge of reading and understanding his books. So this brother, maybe a talib al-ilm or something, tore the cover off of, I think it was Kitab al-Tawheed, and he gave it to this scholar, and he says, Sheikh, I want you to read, you know, look at this to see if this is okay for us to read, because I'm just curious, I don't know. So the Sheikh read and said, you know, this is like, is this Bukhari? You know, what is this? Because it, you know, the usloob is that it's a chapter, and then it gives you evidence for that chapter, or yeah, evidence to illustrate the chapter title, based on the Quran, and then based on the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then maybe some statements of the Salaf and the ulama, best, and then maybe some masail that Muhammad ibn al-Wahhab mentioned. Okay, so that's his usloob. So this scholar, anyway, the Sufi Sheikh, after that, and after he praised the book and said, this is great, and this and that and the other, what is it? And then he told him. And that is the point. So the point is that you have to have hikmah and wisdom. And a last point I want to mention, as the Prophet ﷺ said, about the importance of manners. Because manners also is a way that sometimes you may not have to say anything. People will be impressed if you're a person of good manners, and you're a person who smiles, and you're a person who seems approachable. Then they are attracted to you. That's a natural human response, is that people are attracted to people who are open and friendly towards them. So it's very important that we have manners like the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, trying to follow his example sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam by having good manners and following his speech, which is authentic sunnah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For example, the Messenger alaihi salatu wasallam said, مَا مِنْ شَيْنَ خَلْفِي مَيْزَنَ مُؤْمِنْ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامِ مِنْ حُسْنُ الْخُلْقِ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُبْغِذُ الْفَاحِشَ الْبَدِيءِ. There isn't a thing that weighs heavier on the scale of a believer on the day of judgment than good manners, and verily Allah hates wicked and sinful speech. So that lets us know that we should try to watch our tongues, and it's to know that one of the greatest things we could be doing, aside from Tawheed, and Tawheed has to do with akhlaq as well, but this has to do with the haq and the akhlaq towards your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's where Tawheed fits in. So in a general sense, it's also included in that, and this is in accordance with the statement of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, showing us that this is the sunnah, and this is very important, and this is what attracts people. And there's so many evidences from the sunnah that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, that being gentle, there isn't a thing that doesn't, just as a paraphrase, and the meaning that doesn't, you know, get accomplished or isn't positive, except through rifq, you know, by being rifq, you know, rafiq, you know, having gentleness and kindness. So it's very important. These are very important aspects of da'wah. And that's about all we can say right now in being brief. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.